श्री पीयूष गोयल जी, ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री एंड रेलवेज, डॉक्टर संगीता रेड्डी प्रेसिडेंट फिक्की, मिस्टर राजन भारती मित्तल वाइस प्रेसिडेंट फिक्की एंड वाइस चेयरमैन भारती एंटरप्राइजेस, डेलीगेट्स एंड फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम द मीडिया, इट गिव्स मी ग्रेट प्लेजर टू वेलकम श्री पीयूष गोयल जी, अ वेरी डायनेमिक, एनर्जेटिक, नॉलेजेबल एंड एक्शन ओरिएंटेड मिनिस्टर. द मिनिस्टर हैज बीन एट द फोर फ्रंट ऑफ द आत्मनिर्भर भारत इनिशिएटिव्स. In fact, on a personal note, I must say, whenever I have met Piyush ji, I was always walked out of his office more energized than when I had gone in. He always has a solution to a problem. So I think in today's day and age, it's very valuable. The theme of the annual convention, sir, is Inspired India, and this session would focus on the building blocks of a new India. Sir, we are all inspired by your thoughts when you say, and I quote, good economics makes for good politics. We are today at the cusp of a development explosion. End of quote. When COVID-19 struck and the world came to an almost grinding halt, your government has really converted this crisis into an opportunity for the Indian economy. The pandemic has actually pushed us to think deeper and work faster on a number of reforms and measures, and I'm sure they are helping out the economy in reviving currently and would also help us greatly in the post-pandemic economic recovery. Recent numbers on the economic front are also encouraging. You are aware, sir, that we are closely working with your department on a number of sectors under Atmanirbhar Bharat initiative, where we have already presented strategic roadmaps for AC, electronics, textiles, CCTV, furniture, toys, and drones. We are happy to see progress has been made in a number of these areas, especially in the AC sector, where your government has announced a series of measures to push manufacturing in India, and also industry has given a commitment to achieve the targets as envisaged in the roadmap presented. We have also witnessed announcements of PLI in some of these sectors like textiles and electronics. As I see it, many of these sectors would be an important component of the building blocks of New India. We would continue to engage with your department in this endeavor for the faster implementation of suggestions submitted in each of these sectors. So you are leading a number of flagship programs of the Government of India, like Make in India, Startup India, Ease of Doing Business, Production-Linked Incentives, and many more that are laying a strong foundation or building blocks of a new India. On EODB, if you remember, sir, in the last AGM of FICCI, we had mentioned to you that as an Indian manufacturer, we have to comply with over 2,000 compliances in a year. And if you look at some of the sectoral compliances for pharma or food companies, this could go as high as 6,000. We had submitted a detailed report to Honorable Prime Minister and to yourself last year, sir. I'm happy to share that FICCI is working closely with DPIIT to simplify the rules, regulation, and compliances. It is heartening to see that this issue is being monitored at the level of the Cabinet Secretary. FICCI Task Force on Ease of Doing Business, which has been set up to specifically look at these aspects. We have met several times in the last few months and interacted with DPIIT too. Under this task force, we have several working groups corresponding to the area sectors, and these groups are led by CEOs of their respective areas. A total of over 150 people are working on this project, sir. And among all the major chambers, we have done the maximum amount of work, leagues ahead of others. I am happy to share that many of these working groups, namely textiles, furniture, electronics, corporate law, customs, power, and groups for states like Odisha, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Northeast, UP, and others have completed their work and have submitted 500 suggestions to DPIIT. For few others, work is in progress. Detailed input shall be submitted shortly. I am sure you would agree, sir, that many of these compliances in today's world have outlived their utility, and so can be done away with. And many more can be greatly simplified in the short term to provide immediate relief to industry, and which will then spur growth. We at industry are really looking forward to progressive reforms in this area. With this, sir, I thank you for sparing your valuable time to be here with us, and I would hand back to Sushma. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Somani, for sharing, as always, a pragmatic and candid industry perspective delineating the tireless effort by FICCI over the past months to bring the economy back on track. And now it is time for a very special announcement on Startups Meet Industry series. Promoting startup innovation is a critical building block for the new Inspired India. To make this very special announcement, may I invite Dr. Sangeeta Reddy, President FICCI, and Dr. Ajay Chaudhary, Chair of FICCI Startup Committee and Founder HCL. I request President to share a few words about the series with all of us.
Piyushji, namaste. As always, let me say that we continue to be inspired. Yesterday, in a download of my program or calendar over the year, it was noted that we had over 21 interactions. And like was rightly said by Sandeep, every time we come away more inspired. Today, because of your continuous call for action and positive orientation of the industry, we have two exciting things to share with you. The first one is the work that we've done on startups. We not only called out to all startups during the pandemic and said that FICCI would enable them a free membership. And I'm happy to announce that we currently have 10,000 startups as FICCI members. We have a tremendous team of startup leaders and mentors in the committee, Dr. Ajay Chaudhary, Dr. Saurabh Srivastav, Ms. Padmaja, and all of them have genuine, and of course, Mr. Raju, they have genuine experience in this startup. So I just want to announce to you that we are creating this startup program and a series of Startup Meets Industry, because it's not just about having membership, it's about re-energizing industry through their collaboration with the startups, and it's about giving startups a chance and an opportunity. So I'd like to announce that to you. Moving on to the next agenda, Ajay, thank you so much for your leadership in this area. Moving on to the next agenda, we will also be showcasing to you the extremely exciting expo, which was just launched by the Honorable Prime Minister. So we believe that the expo is a transformational initiative which will help bring small businesses in touch with larger, which will connect a weaver from Varanasi to a buyer in New York and a multitude of other range of things. So we're very happy to do this quick walkthrough to you. We know that in every aspect, you energize commerce, you push for business. And yesterday when you were talking about Brand India and the initiative you're making for Made in India, I'm very happy to say that FICCI will be extremely proud to partner with this initiative and to use this platform of the digital as well as our entire other ecosystem to be a very worthy partner of Made in India. The walkthrough, please.
Good afternoon, sir. Allow me to share my screen. Sir, here we are.
A live walkthrough. Go ahead.
Sir, here we are at FICCI Virtual Convention and Exhibition Center. We will log in as a visitor. So the exhibition has 10 lobbies where more than 2,000 exhibitors from 58 sectors are exhibiting. First, I will take you in Healthcare Pavilion and we will log into one of the stalls in Ayush Hall.
So he's displaying a multitude of stalls.
With exhibitor. Sir, here a visitor can connect with exhibitor through video chat, message, and exchange his e-business card. Honorable Minister, sir, we also have a startup pavilion, which is being represented by over 500 startups from India. So now I will take you to TCS Pavilion, hosted at Industry Pavilion. Honorable Minister, let me take you to State Pavilion and demonstrate One District, One Product exhibition of UP State. Sir, here more than 500 exhibitors from UP State are showcased. Sir, we also have a networking launch where B2B meetings are being held between exhibitors and business visitors. Sir, this is our convention center where global audience are watching us live right now. Honorable Minister, sir, thank you for your time and virtually visiting FICCI Annual Expo.
Honorable Minister, may we please invite you for your address?
Thank you very much, Srimati Sangeeta Reddy ji. My compliments to you on completing your year as the president of FICCI very, very successfully, despite the challenging times that you faced almost throughout your tenure. I believe you have demonstrated the power of our women and clearly have set benchmarks which are going to be tough for your future presidents. I think Uday Shankar takes over today. I wish him all the best and I do hope he will continue with the same spirit, enthusiasm, commitment, zeal and dedication that we saw in you, Sangeeta ji. My compliments and my best wishes to you in all your future endeavors. Of course, as much as I know FICCI, once a FICCI president, you're always going to be involved in FICCI activities. So whenever I've engaged with FICCI, I found the most powerful aspect of FICCI has been the fact that all your previous presidents, Mr. Rajan Mittal, Mr. Sandeep Somani, Mr. Singhania, all of them are continuously engaged in all the activities of FICCI. And I'm sure you will continue this very rich tradition in the years to come. I would also like to thank Sandeep Somani for his very warm welcome. He has also been a very dear friend who has supported the government of India in several ideation of new initiatives. And I do hope this team that I see before me will, as we go forward, be equally engaged with the government to transform Indian business, Indian commerce, and move towards making India a prosperous, a developed nation, a nation which cares for 1.35 billion Indians, and that is respected and trusted across the world. Not only the business world, but also the political world. And I have no doubt in my mind that FICCI will be a very, very integral part of this journey as we go forward. This journey of a new India, this journey of transforming India, and this journey of building a powerful India. I would like to thank FICCI for organizing the FICCI Annual Expo, a glimpse of which I just caught. It's truly impressive that in a short period of time, you've been able to put together such a wonderful digital platform. Sometimes I worry for the exhibition industry that if COVID is going to help come up with such innovative ideas, travel, exhibitions, that physical engagements that were a thing of the normal MICE industry may actually take quite a beating. But I think as we go forward, we will see a mix of virtual and physical combining to help us expand our global outreach, helping us reach out to newer markets, newer customers, newer products. And I'm sure this platform that you have created will play a useful role in that effort also. I would also like to acknowledge the Startups Meet Industry program that you just unveiled. Startups are going to be the backbone of New India. Startups and the ecosystem of startups are encouraging innovation. They are promoting and strengthening new young entrepreneurs, new businesses with new ideas, new ways of doing business. And I'm sure this initiative, in which you already have about 10,000 startups tied in, will help mentor them to become successful startups, move them to sunicorns and unicorns, and we'll see much more of this startup story unfolding in the days to come. While we are at it, I just want to share a thought that I had mentioned earlier also, and seek the cooperation of business leaders from FICCI. If we look at the investments that are going into the startup ecosystem, particularly the early stage seed capital investments, you find that at very low valuations, foreigners are coming and picking up large stakes in our budding startups. I've been terribly concerned about it. Not that I am against foreign capital. We welcome that. But I do think our Indian industry should also reflect and see if we can create a fund of sorts to support early stage investments in startups from all the well-meaning Indian business and industry leaders. Maybe an initial fund of, say, 10,000 crores. It's only $1.25 billion, $1.3 billion. But if we were to create a fund like this, totally run by industry or by whoever you may select or choose to run it, I think thousands of our budding entrepreneurs with good ideas will get an opportunity to scale up, will get your initial support. Because of that, we could also have a mentorship program with the startups. We could also have our Indian industry seeing who can engage with that startup and use the services of that startup. It can be a very holistic program. And I remember Ritesh Agarwal from Oyo had picked up on this idea when I had shared it in one of my engagements. And I do hope that all the titans that I see before me will consider this program, pick it up, and hopefully make it a FICCI-led initiative. Let's see, maybe it should be a competition between FICCI and CII and ASSOCHAM and PhD to see who picks up this initiative and progresses fastest in this. I'll be delighted if FICCI was to give it your best consideration. I would also like to thank FICCI about your role in the various sectoral studies that scale the steering committee for advancement of localization and employment opportunities in India is working on. The studies that you have carried out, the industry engagements have really been very useful. And I do believe that the various PLI programs, the various efforts to sort out the problems that different sectors are facing are bearing fruit in various industries. As I hope my friend Mr. Singhania will acknowledge, the tire and rubber industry ecosystem is one ecosystem that I can clearly see becoming a great business leader in the years to come, where we'll be encouraging rubber plantations through the support of the private sector. We'll be improving the quality of rubber through the support of the private sector, and government on its part will give adequate support to the tire industry so that it can grow, expand and flourish. On similar lines, we have identified another 24 sectors on which work is going on at different levels. The initiative is led by industry. You have your people, your representative in the scale committee. So it's FICCI, CII, ASSOCHAM, and all other sectoral industry leaders who are working together to come up with an actionable agenda to add nearly 200 lakh crores worth of manufacturing in India in the next 10 years. That's an average of about 20 lakh crores of domestic manufacturing being added to India every single year. I believe it's an ambitious program. $300 billion addition to our manufacturing ecosystem will certainly add millions of jobs and work opportunities directly and indirectly. It'll create scale and quality in different sectors and help us to meet the demands of India, the growing demands of 1.3 billion people, while also helping us to expand our international and export outreach. I believe scale of manufacturing coupled with quality and productivity can truly make India competitive in several sectors and help move towards an Atmanirbhar Bharat, which I believe is going to be an important building block of the new India that you and I are both working for, that you and I are both committed to achieve. I must also thank FICCI for their support in our initiative to create a Brand India. The Brand India initiative, ladies and gentlemen, is an idea where government and industry will partner with each other, will develop both on the Make in India side and an overall Brand India side. There are two initiatives. At an immediate level, we are looking at educating consumers, both in India and internationally, about products which are made in India. So we are pushing all industry to certify the Make in India products, if possible also with the value addition component being highlighted in the Make in India component. So if one of you is making sanitary wear, which is 100% domestic, he can proudly say it's a 100% Make in India product. While if somebody else is providing a product which is 70% Make in India, he can equally proudly say that, look, today I'm 70% Make in India, but I'm aspiring to increase my Indian share and provide opportunities to other Indian companies and entrepreneurs, or doing downstream investments to expand my Make in India contribution or value addition. On the second part aspect of the program, we are looking at branding India, something we are all proud of. When we look at branding India, we already have examples like Incredible India, when India was branded as a tourism destination. We have examples like Khadi or the Indian wool being branded very proudly. I think it's time now that, just like you have Swiss brand, that any watch which is of Swiss make, any of you would buy considering that it has to be a good watch, or a machine tool coming from Germany would be considered high quality coming from Germany. On similar lines, it's time that India demonstrates to the world our leadership position and the commitment of quality. Once a product is branded an Indian brand, it should demonstrate to the world, oh, it's an Indian product, it has to be good. That's what you and I have to work towards. We have to propagate this Brand India both in India and internationally, and create pride for our brand. I have suggested that it should be a joint partnership between industry and the government to expand the Brand India program, and I invite FICCI to be a part of this initiative. I have noted Sandeep Ji's point about the high compliance burden. For the last about I would say 1 year and 2 months now, we have been engaged on this problem. Team Lees has come out with several reports on it. FICCI gave us a lot of inputs. We are working both on the macro level and on sectoral levels to see how, and it's a big promise I'm making to you. I promise you I'm working hard to make it happen, but I'm trying to create the first genuine single window in terms of compliances and ease of the approval process. I'm hoping this will be a window which doesn't open into 10 doors behind it. We are making every effort. I have a whole dedicated team working on this. I'm pushing them hard. They're seeking more time. I'm keeping on compressing the time. We are trying to engage with states. We are trying to engage with local bodies, other colleague establishments across the country, and seeing if we can create something which, in simple terms, if I can explain to you, is like the common application form that many of you would have filled up for your children's admission to university, where you have a common application form. All the basic data is available on that form, so you don't have to repeat that 2,000 times. Hopefully that 2,000 will come down, Mr. Somani. And we are working towards that very rapidly also to ease, reduce the burden of repeatedly supplying the same data or repeatedly applying for renewals of licenses. But that common application form with the dead data would be like a DigiLocker. And different departments, if they have any additional information, would be like an annexure, a pop-out annexure for that department. Now, that's the architecture I've explained. Hopefully, if things go well, our technology suppliers do a good job, we do hope to come up with a much, much, much easier process to meet with the compliances while simultaneously working across ministries to see if we can reduce the burden of compliances. Ladies and gentlemen, the government is working on the 3I principle for nation building: inspire, initiate, and innovate. I believe Prime Minister Modi inaugurated your AGM this morning, and I don't think there can be anybody more inspiring in terms of leading the nation to the new India than Prime Minister Modi. He has worked tirelessly and inspired the nation with his vision, simplicity, and courage to think beyond the past, beyond the limitations of the past, and be willing to embrace change, sometimes at great personal cost, sometimes at great causing great misunderstandings amongst the people. But the good part is, he's very clear in his mind that the country has to prosper. 1.3 billion people have to prosper. Laws have to be made for the larger benefit of our society, our different stakeholders, be it our farmers, be it our workmen, labor, be it our education and healthcare services, be it industry, be it commerce, import and export, be it our vibrant services sector, and with a holistic vision of development, reaching the benefits of growth and economic development to the last man at the bottom of the pyramid has been his one unstinted goal. Of course, at times there are misunderstandings, there are times there are political opposition, there are times there are vested interests which try to scuttle change and improvement. I mentioned yesterday that we now realize that the so-called farmer agitation hardly remains a farmer agitation. It has almost got infiltrated by leftist and Maoist elements, a flavor of which we saw over the last 2 days when there were demands, extraneous demands, to release people who have been put behind bars for anti-national activities or who have been put behind bars for illegal activities, demands being raised on a farmer's platform to release so-called intellectuals and poets clearly demonstrate that the effort to delay farmer farm law improvements is probably in the hands of certain elements who are not good for India. I would urge all well-meaning business leaders and all well-meaning intellectuals who are involved with FICCI, who are on this call, on this webcast, to talk about the benefits of these farm laws, to understand the law. Should you have any apprehension, please talk to us. I'm happy to do a separate session on the farm laws if FICCI was to organize it. I'm happy to do a Q&A to address any concerns anybody may have. But I can assure you, these laws are for the benefit of nearly 100 million farmers across the country. This is one government which has been committed to farmer welfare. This is a government which has almost doubled procurement under minimum support price, MSP, which is wrongly sought to be portrayed as being under danger. This is a government that has ensured that farmers get a 50% over their cost of production. This is a government that has increased the agricultural budget nearly 6 times and never before increased to today being nearly $20 billion, 1.34 lakh crores being invested in the agricultural sector. This is a government that's committed to doubling farmers' income. And these laws are but one aspect of the overall effort that we have done in this direction. I would urge all of you to educate the farmers in your sphere of influence. So if some of you has a factory in a particular area, your officials hold a panchayat over there, talk to the local people, understand if they have any misunderstandings or concerns, address them. If you still have any concerns, ask us. Talk to them, explain the benefits, explain how these laws, without changing what the past is, without in any way touching the past systems, opens up new opportunities to do trade and commerce and business for our farmers so that they can go in for more investment. There'll be more investment in rural India. There'll be R&D. There'll be more opportunities for value addition, and therefore farmers can increase their income. I would urge FICCI, particularly those of you with factories or establishments in rural India where there is farming in a big way, to kindly take this project forward and send me a report of the activities that FICCI does in this regard. I would also like to quickly touch upon the fact that Atmanirbhar Bharat, self-reliance, is not about closing the doors of India. It's about opening them wider. It's about greater global engagement. We are not at all suggesting that we are anti-imports. What we wish is that India improves its quality of production, its scale of production. We identify areas where we have competitive and comparative advantages, where we can also become global players, contribute to global trade in a bigger way, while at the same time recognizing we will continue to import high technology products, we'll continue to do technology transfer, we'll continue to work with international companies so that we can bring better products and services to India. So it's a two-way partnership and a greater expansion of our international engagement that Atmanirbhar Bharat talks of. However, there are many products that can be made in India, that can be made very well at competitive prices with good quality in India. I would urge all of you in FICCI to support each other, support Indian industry. If there's a product you can buy in India, even though you may find it slightly cheaper initially to import, but if you support an Indian company, help him improve his quality and scale, he'll certainly become more competitive supplier for you, and you will thereby help create jobs and work opportunities for our young brothers and sisters for the future of India and help strengthen the power of India, help strengthen this resolve of a new India that takes care of 135 crore Indians. I invite all of you to be a part of this journey towards New India. As William Arthur Ward, the British artist, has once said, the pessimist complains about the wind, the optimist expects it to change, the realist adjusts the sails. I invite all of you, with your optimism, to look for a bright future ahead of for all of us in this country, while adjusting the sails along the way to ensure a new India where you and the entire country will have a much, much better future, will have a glorious and prosperous future for 135 crore Indians. Let's shed this pessimistic legacy mindset. Let's build optimism through proper and powerful engagement with each other, and realign our ambition, our vision and objectives to the vision of the Prime Minister of a new India. My compliments to all of you, and certainly today's AGM of FICCI and the annual expo that you have launched is one of the powerful building blocks of the new India that we are seeing in the future. My best wishes to you, Uday Shankarji. Thank you, Sangeeta, for your good work. And thank you, FICCI, for giving me this opportunity. Namaskar. Please stay safe, stay healthy. We pray for your good health, your safety, and the safety and good health of all your near and dear ones. Till we are completely out of the woods, till we have a vaccine and a cure, please continue to maintain social distancing, continue to wear the mask, and continue to encourage all the people in your ecosystem to follow the rules of COVID. Thank you.
Piyush, thank you so much. Before I hand over formally to Rajan for the vote of thanks, I just want to very quickly respond, because as usual, you've inspired us to action. I want to state first on the FICCI startup. We not only have 10,000 members, but the association with Ajay and Saurabh in the committee, they're part of Indian Angel Network, which was the foremost organization bringing entrepreneurial resources. So small businessmen and large businessmen put in and funded startups. So that network is going to get extended tremendously at FICCI. The second is that we look forward to a very powerful partnership between Brand India and the Expo, and we will do everything we can to make this a major success. The third thing on the farm laws, I'm sure Uday will take this up. We wanted to actually organize this interaction, and I think it's a great idea to have you talk to people. We will do an in-camera type session for you. I hand that to Uday. The last point on this tremendous thing of taking the path of ease of doing business onward. Once the portal is up, FICCI will be very happy to become some level of a partner to help implementation in multiple states. So we'll use state offices. Please give us a few states and we'll help accelerate the use and the power of that. Finally, I want to say thank you for the tremendous interactions you've had with us late into the night, deep, patient, insightful, taking copious notes. You have truly been one of the inspirations over the whole year and helped us get through this very, very tough time. Thank you so much for everything. May I please hand over to Rajan? You tempted me to kind of come up and say this because you're always so inspiring. Thank you, Piyush ji. Namaste. May I hand over to Rajan Bharti Mittal, please?
Thank you, President. Honorable Minister, it's always very inspiring to hear you and very reassuring. We can tell you as industry leaders this morning when we heard the Prime Minister and then Nitin Gadkari ji, and now you have spoken, the theme, the government is in complete sync, and the way that the whole game plan we can see from outside inside is that everybody's playing in tandem. And I think India can be a very trustworthy, reassuring, and a long-term partner for the global supply chain, for the manufacturing exports, and the kind of vision that you are setting it up for the industry. We will play our role. That's a given. Without the partnership between government and industry, India or Brand India will not progress. And honestly speaking, is always so good to see a passionate minister who's betting for the industry. And the good part is you have seen that part of the world as well before you came into politics full time. So that's very reassuring for us to understand that we can come to you with our problems. You will understand, you will appreciate. And yes, India is a large machine. States are involved, centers involved. So we have to partner everybody. We have to take everybody along. And clearly you can see when you do the tough reforms, like the farm bills that you've got, please don't step back. Industry will back you up. It will be a tough journey, tough road, but then we have ministers like you who will passionately bat for it. I can assure on behalf of FICCI and all the industry leaders that you will not be government, and you in particular as our minister, the industry will not come be less wanting. Udays will take this challenge on the startups, as you've said. And I think India will, within our lifetime, I can say, will be seen as a global brand, a global leader. Thank you very much for taking this time out. And we all will stay safe. Please also stay safe. We are all batting in the 90s. We must complete the century. It'll be tough to get out at this stage. So thank you very much for giving this time.